dimensions and scale factors. To be good at scale factors, you need to review fractions. Questions 1, 2, and 3 are a review of fractions. The directions say find each quotient. Write your answer as a fraction or a mixed number. Let me just give you a review here real quick. A fraction would be 11 over fifths. An equal mixed number is 2 and 1 fifth. Okay, this is the fraction. This is the mixed number. They are equal to each other. Do you know the meaning of quotient? That means the answer after you divide something. For example, the quotient of 10 and 2 is 5. The quotient is 5. Okay, I have number 1, 2, and 3 on my board here. Let me help you with the math. We have a mixed number, but we want to change that into just a fraction. Let's change 6 and 1 fourth into a fraction. Let's change 2 into a fraction. Starting with this 6 and 1 fourth. Well, this is equal to 6 plus 1 fourth. Did you know that? 6 and 1 fourth is exactly equal to 6 plus 1 fourth. Now, let's get this number 6 into a fraction. What fraction equals 6 that has a denominator of 4? We need the same denominator. So you know you want the denominator to be 4, and it must be equal to 6? Well, 6 times 4 is 24. 24 fourths equals 6. Plus this 1 fourth. So that is 25 fourths. We went from this number all the way down to this number here. I just moved it down here, and I did all the steps to show you how I went from a mixed number to a fraction. Okay, now the number 2. This whole number, I want to write that as a fraction. 2 over 1. Great. So I have rewritten our problem down here. 25 fourths divided by 2 over 1. Remember that when you divide fractions, you can cross multiply. Let me draw the arrows in to help you remember what I'm talking about. The numerator times the denominator is the new numerator, 25. The denominator times the numerator becomes the denominator, 8. So the answer is 25 over 8. If cross multiplication is not comfortable for you, don't worry, there's another way to do it. Take this first fraction here, 25 fourths. It is being divided by 2 over 1. So instead of dividing, you can multiply by the reciprocal. Let me say that again. 25 fourths divided by 2 over 1 is exactly the same as 25 fourths times 1 half. Just take the reciprocal here. Take this number and multiply it here. This is the reciprocal. Okay. Let me do the math. 25 over 4 times 2, 8. So I multiplied straight across. 25 times 1 is 25. 4 times 2 is 8. Look, I get the same answers. So which do you prefer? Do you like to cross multiply? Or do you want to just multiply by the reciprocal? Both give the same answer. But I don't like this answer. 25 eighths is not a comfortable number. I want a nice and comfortable number. How many times does 8 go into 25? Right, 3 times. And what do you have left over? 1/8. So the answer is 3 and 1/8. fraction. So 10 times 7, that's 70. Plus this 1, that is 71 over 7. I rewrote this number as a fraction. And let's rewrite the 5 as a fraction. That's 5 over 1. What is 71 divided by 5? Let's cross multiply. 71, wait, I want to change my color. There. No, there, that's what I want. 71 times 1 becomes the numerator. 71. 7 times 5 becomes the denominator. 35. Okay, there's our answer, but I don't like this fraction. 71 over 35ths. 71 35ths, I mean, that's not comfortable to work with. It is equal to 35 plus 35 plus 1 over 35. Okay, I did that because I'm showing you how I'll reduce this fraction. 71 is equal to 35 plus 35 plus 1. And then I kept the denominator the same. So what is this equal to? This is equal to 35 over 35 plus 35 over 35 plus 1 over 35. Well, 35 over 35 is equal to 1. 35 over 35 is equal to 1. So this is 1 plus 1 plus 1 35th because we cannot reduce that 35th again. I need to go this way now. So I get 1 plus 1 is 2 plus 1 35th. The answer is 2 and 1 35th. Let's keep going. Next problem. 8 and a half divided by 11. Whenever I do fractions, I try to think about it first. Do I expect the number to be greater than 1 or less than 1? If you have 8 and a half bag of chips divided by 11 students, do each of you get your own bag of chips? No, there's not enough bags of chips for 11 students. So that means the number will be less than 1. Okay. I'll just keep that in mind. I'm expecting the quotient to be less than 1. Let's take this 8 and a half by 11 and change that into a fraction. 8 times 2 is 16, plus this 1 is 17, and the denominator is 2. Did you see how I got that? Divided by, let's take this 11 and put it into a fraction, 11 over 1. Okay, I'm going to rewrite this as 17 over 2 times 1 over 11. Did you see what I did? When I rewrote it from here to here, I just took the reciprocal. I will multiply by the reciprocal. So I can multiply straight across. 17 times 1 is 17. 2 times 11 is 22. The answer is 17 22nds. That fraction is kind of uncomfortable for me, but it doesn't have any common factors between the numerator and denominator, so we cannot reduce it down any further. We have to live with that fraction. I'll show you how to type these numbers into GeoGebra. Do you remember what the answers are? I hope you wrote them down. If you didn't write them down, you're going to have to do it again. Then you can type in your answers. Lucky for you, I'm good at math in my head, so I'll just go ahead and do it. 10 and 1/7 divided by 5, well, I look at this a totally different way. 10 divided by 5 is 2. 1/7 divided by 5 is 1/35. So the answer is 2 and 1/35. Now let me type that in. 2 and 1/35. You can type it in like that. I like to use the and right there so that you're sure where your whole number stops and your fraction begins. Okay, next one. Oh, I'm sorry. I skipped the first one. let me go back up here. 6 1/4 divided by 2 equals 3 1/8. Okay, let's type that in. 3 1/8. Now, these are exactly the same problems that I just finished doing on my Jamboard. You wrote them down, didn't you? Because I don't want you to just copy my answers. Now I'm showing you how to type them in. So type it in like this, 3 1/8, 2 1/35. But don't just copy me. Make sure you did the math too. Uh-oh, what's 8 1/2 divided by 11? Don't worry, I wrote it down. I'll show you how to type in the answer. It is 17/22, so I'll just do 17/22, 17/22. Okay, good job, guys. You need to study these fractions. If it was confusing for you, don't just copy me and keep going. Get a piece of paper and do the math yourself. Follow the steps that I showed you. Make sure you do it together. See you in the next